But what we believe is happening is that the mullet, which have been out to sea for the winter, come back into the river and they migrate up here and they sit in the mouth of this channel, basically washing themselves in a stream of fresh water. Now, either that's to reacclimatise with fresh water, or quite likely they do it because the fresh water will kill off any fish lice and salt water infections that they have. And you see that one or two of these have got quite nasty fungal infections. So I'm guessing that the fresh water will clean that off. Fascinating. It's like a susurration of starlings. They're swimming around, formating with each other. Hopefully, the underwater camera is getting this. And you won't get an idea of scale on these, but there are some big fish amongst this. They're all. Very few under 2 pound. I think there's quite a few that go up to about 4 pound here. Some nice little fish. This year we want to answer that question: how do you catch bloody mullet?
As you can see, the fish are not feeding, they're not breeding, they all look in fairly poor condition, and all they're doing is just wallowing in this stream of fresh water that comes from a winterbourne through a sluice gate and into the main channel. I find it fascinating. I'm going to leave you with the fish now. And the music of Mother Nature.
When the tide goes out, which will be really quite quick soon, that goes right down to maybe 2 feet deep.
And it's still packing?
No, only a few, right at the end where it drops off.
Yeah.
Because they're shy, but in between now and then,
yeah,
you should get, they come down this bank down here and join this lot. There was maybe 300 yesterday.
Wow.
Of course, as each one starts to feel well enough, its fungus has been cured, you know.
They then move out back in the river.
They go off and they don't come back in.
Yeah.
I mean, we did count, when the BBC were here, we counted about 1,000 in that pool at one time.
Wow.
But the most I've seen this year is 500, and then the seal came in and spooked a lot of them.
Yeah.
And didn't come back.
I'm surprised. Well, I suppose there's nowhere here for the seal to pull up. They're not going to get disturbed by dogs and beetles. So.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, occasionally it sits on the pontoon when it's got a full belly down there at the rowing club. And last year, it accidentally went right through the sluice and into the reed beds out there, which took about 2 days to chase it out. I don't know why people bothered chasing it out. I was quite happy that it had gone in there. And I managed to get a good photo or two. But there were three last year that were living in this stretch of the river.
Right.
Two females and a male.
Yeah.
And they reckon they'll get through, on average, five of these a day.
Not sure.
And over the year, they overwintered them as well.
Camera.